room, do I?
Sister, along with Louie and Flo and her brother John, who are unable to be here. I welcome you to this service and thank you on their behalf for being here to share in this time for Edna, who passed away at Peel Bethany Aged Care on Sunday, the 18th of January 2015, after a short struggle with her health, born so bravely, as Edna was still laughing with her sister June less than 24 hours earlier. My name is Jill Parnham, and as a funeral celebrant, it has been my privilege to work alongside Kate Ersig, the funeral director from here at Just Cremations, and to gently guide Edna's family to bring this service to you today. As we look back over time, we find ourselves wondering, did we remember to thank you enough for all you have done for us, for all the times you were beside our sides to help and support us, to celebrate our successes, to understand our problems and accept our defeats, or for teaching us by your example the value of hard work, good judgment, courage and integrity. We wonder if we ever thanked you for the sacrifices you made to let us have the very best, and for the simple things like laughter, smiles and times we shared. If we have forgotten to show our gratitude enough for all the things you did, we are thanking you now, Mum, and we are hoping you knew all along how much you meant to us. As I sat with Edna's family, they shared with me a little of her devoted life. It is my honour to share that with you. Edna Routledge was born in Choppington, Northumberland, England, on the 26th of March 1927, to parents Florence Ellen, known as Florrie, and Joseph, known as Joe Routledge. She came from a large family, having three brothers and six sisters. Edna was educated firstly at Scotland Gate in Choppington, then Guidepost School, also in Choppington. After leaving school at about 15, she began a long career working in hospitality. While still very young, Edna met Daniel Snedden, a soldier, at a dance. The couple soon married and welcomed three children into their lives, Louis, Danny and Joe. However, this marriage was not to last and the couple soon went their separate ways. Some time later, while at a dance, Alexander Swan, now deceased, caught Edna's eye. She and Alex married on the 22nd of January 1955. This marriage welcomed Margaret and Alex into Edna's fold. She later married George Burns, whom she met while working in a pub. The couple married on the 17th of January 1970 in Albany, Western Australia. Eddie then joined the family. Life was not always easy for Edna, but somehow she seemed to make ends meet with the odd job she would take on and her willingness to ensure her family were always cared for. Edna's family remembered her amazing baking skills and the beautiful bread and stotty she would make for them. For those of you like me who do not know what stotty is, it is a flat disc of bread traditionally made from leftover dough and baked on the coolest part of a coal-fired oven. Alex recalled a time with Edna back in England when he was a young boy For some reason, Alex filled Edna's lounge room with pigeons. As you can imagine, Edna was not too pleased with this and gave Alex some disciplinary action before they managed to get the birds out of the house. As they let the pigeons out, they all flew up and landed on the roof, which was possibly good for Alex, as Edna laughed and laughed at this. There were many amusing moments spent with Edna over her life, and all family members were able to recount some of these. June recalled how she was so relieved when Edna gave up her driving licence. She had two speeds, flat out and stop. And everybody knows that. In fact, the family described her as a maniac on the roads. Edna had two significant bingles to mention. She was in a petrol station on one occasion. When she went to leave, a police car had pulled in behind her. Edna became so flustered she put her car in reverse and hit the police car. On another occasion, she was pulled over for an RBT. After doing the test, as she went to drive off, she backed into the police car. On another occasion, Edna went to the forum. When she returned to her car to leave, she discovered she had locked her keys in the car and it was still running. When Edna moved out of her car and into the gopher, things did not change too much with her driving skills. She still retained her flat out and stop routine, and her family had to continue to worry. Edna even took herself from Manjo to Pinjarra in her gopher. She loved being out and about in it. She drove her vehicles and she lived her life full on. Despite her not so good driving ability, Edna was a wonderful mother who was described to me as the family rock, excellent and the best. She was always there for her kids and her grandchildren and loved every one of them unconditionally. She was not afraid to be seen outside playing cricket or having some other fun with them. Edna always enjoyed her children and grandchildren, so much so that her family found it difficult to find a photo of Edna without a child on her lap. She also babysat for others and often wouldn't charge the family as she enjoyed her time so much with her little charges. Edna loved music of all sorts. She also loved to dance. She knitted profusely and loved to settle down with a Catherine Cookson novel to read. She had a beautiful singing voice, but reserved that for her family only. As the years passed her by, Edna would sit at the computer, play solitaire and listen to music. It was eventually deemed necessary for Edna to be placed into care about 13 months ago, and it was then that she was admitted into Peel Bethany Aged Care and was fortunate enough to have her ex-daughter-in-law Sandra looking after her as one of her carers. While in Peel Aged Care, Eddie still picked Edna up and took her home to watch queer movies, as she referred to his choice. They would sit together and watch 3D movies, and all the while Edna would be ducking and diving while watching. Sometimes she could be more entertaining than the movie. On these visits home, Edna was always trying to help Eddie with the washing or cleaning up. In her twilight years, her first thoughts were still always for her family. Sadly, Edna passed away after suffering a chest infection. She will be sadly missed by all her family. May she rest in peace. As Elvis sings The Wonder of You, a song which was special to Edna and June, I invite you to sit back and watch the DVD tribute which her family had lovingly created in her honour. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Respect. Once the family have been forward, you, her friends, are invited to do the same. We do ask at this time that you do not stop to offer your condolences to family members, return to your seats and allow them to silently reflect on Edna and all that she's meant to them. There will be time after the service to offer your condolences. Perhaps you could spare a thought for those family members who are so far away today and unable to be here. We know that their thoughts will be with Edna and all her loved ones. Thank you.
Understand,
Edna's family would like to publicly acknowledge and thank the wonderful staff and carers of Peel Bethany Aged Care for the care she has received while she's been a resident. Also to the staff at Peel Health Campus who cared for Edna during her stay with them. To each staff member who assisted Edna over this time, the family thank you for your care, kindness and compassion shown to not only Edna, but to her family also. Thank you will never seem enough. For those who wish, please join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, for those for whom it is comfortable to do so, could you please stand as I offer your final farewell to Edna Burns, a much-loved family member and friend. Before I do say farewell to Edna, I ask you to be grateful once more for the
It's hard when you get the light coming through the window, isn't it? It's a bit hard. I don't know why I stuck with this job. Thank you.